So if you could just keep it running. Don't end it. Like, yours is like 10 minutes. So you're really limiting her options. You want her to sit plus.
Yeah, and then I'll get side over here.
Right.
Just got a little bit longer. And I just made it comfortable with me touching her on the muscle then and holding it in her mouth slightly. Right.
Behavior is to lay down.
That's, well, she thinks she has to do it.
That's what she does.
She loses the. Hey! No. Just then I've got a little bit more.
Wow, that was pretty good. 2 seconds.
Yeah. Take my hand out so she knows that. There it is.
So why are you putting the doll behind your mouth, your back?
Huh?
You're taking it. You're removing it from her sight. Why?
That because I wanted to see it. Right? So look, Plutz.
Plutz.
Plutz. Plutz. So why I'm I wanted why
here,
I'm doing
here, I'll
that?
Just tell it to Plutz.
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 Why I'm doing that is that if I have to use negative reinforcement to do the object, then I wanted to associate that when I do that timing later, when you see the object, you grab hold of it.
Okay.
So the idea of it is when I bring it out later, is that as soon as you see it, quickly grab hold of it, you will keep off the negative, right? That's why. And I want to say that when she sees it, she grabs it really quickly with a positive mindset for this and the positive reinforcement. She sees it, she wants to grab it really quickly to be able to get the click to happen.
Right.
Right? That's where we want to get the speed. But you watch the video with the, for everyone out there who's watching this, who saw Jane's video that we posted with the Dutch Shepherd in the box learning to retrieve the newspaper. You can see the dog actually at one point there quickly opened the box, he dropped the newspaper on the ground, then he picked it up. Then the next time he did it, he opened, he pulled it out a little bit and then he had it. In the end, he didn't drop it anymore. He just dragged it out of the mailbox and went really quickly.
Uh-huh.
We wanted to do that. We wanted to learn that her speed and her quickly holding it brings the reward more quickly. Right? Doing that gets the reward more quickly. And you will see dogs do exactly the same thing, and the handlers make the error, especially in the part C of the protection work. They're trying to teach us a blind search, and the dog shortcuts. Doesn't do 3 and 4 blinds, it runs straight to the target blind and gets there. But we can talk about what we do to show the dog that this is an unsuccessful behavior, right? The same as when she dropped it there before you sort of there, it was an unsuccessful behavior because it never produced the reward, right?
Uh-huh.
So, yeah. You ready?
Oh, now she sits, huh?
So now she's learning that even if she's laid down, right? she has to get up and touch the dumbbell to get the hook to get the reward, right? Right? So, the dog really is making a conscious choice to do that behavior. It's elected to do it, right? So, it's trying to control what it's doing. So, it does that there? No. Right. The only time the click happens is when it's in and out. So, what we're looking to teach the dog is the last behavior first. The only way you can get fed is have that in your mouth and let go of it when you hear the click. Huh? So we've actually taught it to let go first. People will go, no, you haven't. No, you have to have it in your mouth before you can let go of it, before the click happens. Letting go is the last behavior. Huh? But you have to have something in your mouth to let go of it to get the click.
Right.
So we're doing what's called back chaining. We're teaching the last behavior first, and then we're going to work backwards, right? Until we get the very first behavior that we want is sit, pay attention, go to the dumbbell, pick it up, and then come back to us. The last behavior that the dog does here is let go of it in front of us. And then it does the next basic position. So we teach the last thing first, which is let go, and then we just shape it. Prayer, right? I'll ask for it, give me a little tension here. I don't click, but I just let her do that, because I want to make clear her clear in this, what we're training here, what that click is for.
And that's for holding the dumbbell.
That's for holding the dumbbell in this scenario. Right? Hey.
She likes to paw too, huh?
Yeah. So then I'll give her a lot of food. So this is enough for her today. Mm-hmm. She's learnt the first step, right? She's learned the first step.
So that's all I do with her?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Today's, this is enough for her. Good girl.
Good girl.
Good girl.
Yeah. Huh? That's so good. Okay. Done.